In this video, we are going to cover the new features included in the Power Query October 2014 update. As you can see, we have 6 new features or improved features in the product in this update. The first 3 all belong to the query editor area of the product, so I'm going to go ahead and switch to a new workbook, to a workbook where I have a table defined in my worksheet. And in this case, I'm going to go to the Power Query tab and click From Table to get that table into the query editor. The first feature that I wanted to show is the ability to use the column headers as the first row of data, which is possible now through the Home tab right next to Use First Row as Headers. I could use headers as first row, and you see how we push the headers down to the first row of data. This is very useful in cases where the data that you're trying to consume is not formatted properly, and you'll need to perform some additional transformations. So in this case, you see how we easily push the headers down, which of course is the inverse operation from pushing them up, which is something that has been available in Power Query for quite a bit now. Great, so let's go ahead and remove those 2 steps. The next thing that I want to show you, the feature number 2, is the ability to specify the column names, the new column names up front when you combine columns, combine multiple text columns into a single column. And for that, I'm going to go ahead and select my first name and last name columns, and I'll go into the Transform tab and I'll click Merge. And now I'm given the option to select the delimiter or separator between the values in each of these columns, as well as the new column name. So before this update, you have to have defaulted to merge for this new column name, and then manually rename it in a subsequent step, or modify the generated formula in the formula bar. Now you could do that up front, and you see how I get my full name column right away. The third feature that I wanted to highlight is the quick access toolbar that we've added in the query editor window. As you can see, I have a bunch of buttons pinned already to my quick access toolbar. I could go ahead and remove them. So this is the default state where I have just this Smile and Frown drop-down menu in this toolbar, and we decided to add that because it makes Smile and Frown much more discoverable than it usually was, because it was only present in the Home tab. So when you were working on a different tab like Transform or Add Column, you wouldn't be able to reach directly to us from there. But this also opens up a bunch of other possibilities for you to customize your query editor environment in Power Query. So for instance, if I wanted to pin something to the quick access toolbar, it's just as easy as going to the button that I want to pin from the ribbon, for instance, the Advanced Editor button, which is under the View tab. And I could add that to the quick access toolbar, and now, no matter which tab I am on, I'll be able to click this button to access that capability, and it would just behave as if you were accessing it from the ribbon. Of course, I could also pin more complex controls, like for instance the drop-down for split column. I could add that to the QAT, quick access toolbar, and now I'm able to access all of the options within that drop-down and also get the same experience as if I would coming in from the ribbon. And something that's probably obvious, but you'll be able to keep all of these customizations across different times that you use Power Query, including also when you update to a newer version of the product, maybe next month or the month after when we release a new version. Okay, so that would be for number 3. Number 4, it's about making it more evident that you get stale preview in your query previews in some cases. So in this case, you see how the data was just downloaded a couple of minutes ago, which is when I first used this table. But there's cases in which when you reconnect to a data source that you've used maybe a few days or weeks ago, we would actually use that same preview of data that we got back then. And while we display in the status bar the last time where we refreshed that preview, it's not, you know, it doesn't get highlighted enough in cases where the data is stale. So we decided to add a yellow bar that spans above the preview, from side to side of the preview, that will tell you that the preview is older than a few days, will actually tell you how old it is, and will give you the chance to click the refresh button, which of course you could have done through the refresh preview button in the ribbon, but now we made it much more clear to you that you probably want to do that right away from the yellow bar. Great. the next to last feature, function invocation from search, it's about making it much more smooth to consume functions from the Power BI data catalog. So I'm gonna go quickly through the process of defining one function. I'm going to connect to a SQL Server database that I connect very often to, which is my Northwind database, and I'm going to pick the customers table, and I'm going to edit it. So now that I'm looking at the customers table, what I would like to do maybe is filter by a specific country. So I'll just get customers, let's say from Brazil, for instance. And the next thing that I would like to do is pull the number of orders that each of these customers has done over time. And for that, I could leverage the navigational columns that we add at the end of the table for tables that contain relationships. In this case, I'm going to remove the customer demographics one. I'm not interested on that. But I would like to use the orders one. And what I would like to do, instead of expanding fields from the other table, is actually do an aggregate. And what I would like to aggregate is the count of order ID, which effectively will give me the count of orders. So you see how I get that column now. And let me rename that to count of orders. And let me move that to the beginning of the table as well. So now we have it as the leftmost column, and we could also sort this descending, so I get the customers with most orders on top. Okay, so now that I have customers with most orders per country, what I would like to do is actually, rather than just looking at Brazil, giving the I would like to give the end user the ability to specify which country they would like to look at. So for that, I could go into the advanced editor and turn this into a function, specifying that I want to pass in one parameter, which is country, and then replacing country in the step where I filter out the column. So I'll remove Brazil and instead just say country has to equal that value that the end user specified when they invoke this function. So now that I have this as a function, I'm going to be able to close and load the editor and get my query into the workbook queries pane. So you see how we already treat this slightly different from all of the other queries. We give it a different icon to indicate that this is a function. We automatically disable loading this query to the worksheet because it doesn't quite make sense, because it doesn't yield any data results yet. But what I could do now is invoke, and I'll get this dialog where I could specify which country I want. Let's say that I want Spain. Then I get to preview this data. I maybe could make some changes here, maybe remove that column, click close and load, and I get a new function. So this is all existing capabilities before this update, but the part where it gets interesting now is how I can go back to my function query, and if I'm signing to Power BI for Office 365, I'll be able to send this query to the data catalog. So I'll do just that, and you see how I get this sharing experience, this send to data catalog experience, where I can specify name, description. I'm going to say that I don't want to share a preview and that I would like to share this with everyone in my enterprise, everyone on Microsoft using Power BI. And I'll click send to data catalog. And now that I've sent this query to the catalog, let's go and open a new workbook. And let's imagine that I'm a completely different user. I'm a business user right now who would like to find some reports within my enterprise about customers with the most orders. Customers with most orders. So I'll search for that on online search, and I get a set of organizational results from which the first one is actually the one that I just shared a minute ago. And from here, as opposed to with other results like this one, for instance, which is a table where I get a preview and I'm able to load or edit. In this case, since this was a function, what I'm able to do is directly invoke it from here. And I could also do that with double click. So if I double click, I get the exact same experience as I was getting in my current workbook. And I'm able to get those results and preview them and perform additional transformations. Finally, if I click close and load, it will just land in my worksheet as you would expect. The other thing that I could do with these search results, if I really wanted to, is the ability to right click and say, I'm going to add this definition of a query to my workbook. So I still cannot customize the definition of that query, but I'll still be able to add it here as a shortcut. So if I want to invoke it again to get a new query with a new result, I don't need to go back to the search results or search for it again and find it. I can just reuse it from the current workbook. All right, so we're down to the last improvement, which is about preserving number formats in the worksheet when we refresh queries. So let's take this query as an example, the one that I just landed with the count of orders. Let's assume for a second that this was something else, that this was a currency value, and I would like to format that as euros since these were customers from Spain. So now that I've applied that number format in Excel, before this update, when you click refresh, these numbers, this formatting would go away. Now when I click refresh, as you can see, it stays. And this builds on top of a bunch of other conditional formatting rules that we could apply and that we've supported for a while. So now you could really turn this worksheet table into a report, and rest assured that when you go back to Power Query and maybe modify something else on this query, as long as it doesn't impact the column where you are applying this formatting, it will just keep the format. So I remove one column, company name, and you see how the first column still keeps the same formatting. Okay, that's all for this October Power Query update. We, of course, are always happy to hear from you, and we hope you keep sending us a lot of feedback. And please stay tuned, because I'll just say the next one or two updates will have tons of new features, and I think you'll definitely like them. See you then.